Hi everyone, this is Heather Lottinen from the Flourish Academy. This is episode 477. Today we're talking about what it takes to be a wedding photographer. Now, I've done videos in the past about the minimum gear requirements to shoot a wedding, but let's go over that really quickly. You would need a 24-70 f/2.8, a 50mm 1.8 or 1.4, 70-200 2.8, two camera bodies and two flashes. That's the minimum gear you would need to photograph weddings. And some would argue that you probably also need a macro lens in order to do ring shots. But those are the requirements for shooting a wedding in terms of gear. But we've talked about that in the past. Today, we're talking about what it takes to be a wedding photographer. Okay, you have to be okay with having absolutely no control. You can't control the time of day the wedding takes place. You can't control the weather, the location, the venue, the church lady. You can't control the people. You have zero control, yet you are expected to produce amazing results. Now, that type of pressure is not for everyone. I think it takes a certain personality to photograph weddings. And what I have found when instructing photographers over the years is that people seem to either love weddings or hate weddings, but they usually know pretty quickly after they have photographed one. They're like, that is way too much pressure. And other people, myself included, thrive on that pressure. I love the challenge of creating amazing photographs when I have zero control, because that to me is the true test of a photographer. I can't control the light. I can't find the best location. I just have to make it work. If it's pouring down rain, if the sky is dark, if the location is ugly, if the crazy church lady is breathing down my neck telling me I have to hurry. I mean, you have to have a certain type of personality to do that. Okay, so that's one thing. You have to thrive in an environment of, I don't want to use the word chaos, but pretty close. You also have to have the ability to work with a lot of different types of personalities. Not everyone is super kind. My clients were all amazing, but sometimes you would have extended family that are just like almost impossible, and you think, I'm just trying to do a job here, so how about you help a sister out and just get in the photo and stop complaining about it? So it takes the ability for you to deal with personalities and to use your own personality in order to get what you need. Again, for me, I thrive in that environment. I'm an extrovert, I love people, and I love challenging people because, again, I love challenges. When I signed up to be a wedding photographer, I also recognized that I would be working every Saturday in the summer, and it didn't bother me. I loved it. It didn't bother me. You know, you miss some birthday parties, you miss some graduation parties, you miss some family reunions, and you're just kind of like, it's okay because this is my job, and I love it, and it's what I signed up for. But sometimes you'll start to think, okay, now I missed my kid's birthday, okay? And what are you gonna think when you miss your first funeral because you had to shoot a wedding? You know, if somebody hires Weddings by Heather, they want Heather. They don't want another photographer. Now, I networked with a bunch of other photographers in my area, and we all do this to back each other up in case of emergency. But the thing is, if you have a wedding scheduled, whether you like it or not, that is your top priority. That, in fact, is your only priority, is that wedding. Are you okay with that? I was. I loved it. It didn't matter to me until it did. I mean, I was probably about maybe 13 years in when I was like, okay, I'm gonna get a little more particular about when I schedule these weddings and make sure that I'm not scheduling anything near my children's birthdays. I mean, I just don't want to do that, right? But you can't plan for funerals, and you certainly can't plan for emergencies. Now, I always had this rule with my mom. She cared for my children when they were really little and I was shooting weddings. I always said to her, if anything happens, and I mean anything, do not call me because there's nothing I can do about it. Let me finish the wedding and then you can call me. I mean, okay, I was talking about this with my friend Taryn the other day, and she's like, Heather, I don't know. I mean, if something really serious happened with one of my kids, I'm talking life-threatening injury or even loss of life, she's like, I would want to know. And I said, okay, So let's say your mom calls you or your babysitter calls you. You're photographing the formals right after the ceremony. Hey, your kid was involved in an accident. What are you going to do? Leave the wedding? Well, you're going to feel like, yeah, you have to leave the wedding. Well, then who's going to shoot the wedding? You can't leave the wedding. But wait, you have to leave, but you can't. So my point there is I did not want my mom to ever, never, ever call me no matter what. And I told her, I gave her all kinds of scenarios. I said, if someone dies, they are already dead. If they're already dead and there's nothing I can do about it, you can wait a couple of hours and let me know on my way home from the wedding. Let me shoot the wedding. Do not disturb me. Now, primarily, I did not have my phone on me during weddings for that reason. I didn't want to know. I distinctly remember one wedding in 16 years where my mom called me and I didn't have my phone, so I didn't see it. But it was like towards the end of the evening. I was still photographing the reception. We were maybe it was like an hour before we were leaving. So we were wrapping up. I looked at my phone. It was in my bag. And I saw a missed call from her. And I was like, whoa. So, I mean, I knew something was serious and wrong because she would not call me. So I like sneak in the hallway. I call her and I'm like, Mom, what's going on? And she's like, listen, everything's okay. But Evan fell and he split open his head. And she goes on to tell me this whole story. And I said, he's okay. And she said, he's fine. There was just blood everywhere. It was a whole scene. And I said, but he's fine. And I said, Mom, thank you. Don't ever call me again. Don't. No. Please do not call me because now I'm worried. I finished up the wedding and it wasn't a huge deal because it really wasn't that bad. But I said, you could have texted me and said, hey, give me a quick call on your way home. Anything, but don't. I mean, I don't want to use the word mad with my mother, but because I love her dearly. But I was like, Mom, don't call me. Okay. The reason this is coming full circle is because this past Friday at 6 a.m., my very good friend Leanne texted me and she said, are you available to shoot a wedding tomorrow? So this is Friday morning at 6 a.m. I instantly knew that something was very, very wrong. Leanne has never missed a wedding. She's not going to miss a wedding. Something is wrong. So I sent her a text back immediately and said, I'm available. I'm there for you. We'll start charging batteries, whatever you need. And I didn't even know what was happening. And it turns out that her dad is in the hospital in very, very near death. And in fact, he's gone home. He's on hospice right now and doesn't have much longer to live. And she just didn't know how it was going to play out or what she was going to do. But she had said to me, my goal is to be at that wedding. I will be at that wedding. I will photograph that wedding because there's nothing I can do for him. But I just want to know that you're available should I need backup. And she ended up shooting the wedding. I was just like on call in case something happened. But she even said to me, like, if something happens, there's nothing I can do about it. I have to shoot this wedding. So part of being a wedding photographer is being able to compartmentalize. You have to be there for your bride and groom on the most important day of their life, even if someone you love has passed or is about to, or something very serious is happening. You have to be able to shut that down and focus. That is a skill. Certainly you can learn it, but not everybody has the ability to do that. Leanne and I are both very, very good at compartmentalizing. I have a job, I'm gonna photograph, I'm gonna use my adrenaline to keep me going, and then I will deal with whatever I need to deal with. I have missed funerals. This might be too much information, but I have had several miscarriages. I was pregnant 6 times. I have 2 kids. Those aren't good odds, but it all works out. It's okay. One of those miscarriages occurred whilst shooting a wedding. If you've ever been in that scenario, besides like emotionally draining, it was extremely, extremely physically painful. And I was photographing a wedding with a smile on my face. I mean, think about it. What am I gonna do? I'm in the middle of a wedding. This starts to happen. I start to get intense pain. I know what's happening. What am I gonna say to the bride? You know what? I'm not feeling real well, so I'm gonna have to leave. I mean, you can't do that. You can't do that. No one ever knew that was happening to me. I have photographed weddings very, very seriously ill without them knowing because you have to be there, again, compartmentalize. You have to be there for your clients and you'll be surprised what you can do with adrenaline. It's why athletes can play a game basically with a broken leg. It's because of adrenaline. But my question to you is, do you have that ability? Are you okay missing a funeral, the death of a loved one? You know, again, things like graduation parties or family reunions or birthday parties, that's one thing. And that can be kind of disappointing. But the first time you miss a funeral, you're like, oh, wow, this is a, being a wedding photographer is a very serious commitment. So you have to be able to be committed to it, and you have to be able to compartmentalize. The two C's, I just made that up. Commitment, compartmentalize. Can you do it through a series of emergencies? Or when your kids are real little and they're hanging on you and they're crying, don't leave mommy, don't leave, don't leave. Are you okay leaving them? I was, because I was like, listen, I'll see you suckers later. I love weddings and you do nothing but cry, so I'm out of here. I distinctly remember my daughter Ella, when she was little, saying to me once, crying, sobbing as I was leaving. She says, you always leave me. You always leave me. And I smiled at her and I said, she was really little, you guys. I said, false. I leave one day a week. Just happens to be Saturday. But I'm here every other day. You're going to be okay. You'll have fun with your grandma. No worries. If none of this fits your personality or your value system, then weddings may not be for you. I was working with a photographer recently who is very established and considering starting weddings, a branch to her business. I asked her a series of questions along these lines, and everyone I asked her, she was like, no, no, no. And so I said, do you think that you would be equipped for weddings, just, you know, personality-wise, value standpoint? And she's like, absolutely not. And I'm so glad we had this conversation, because it takes a certain personality to work under these conditions. Personally, people like myself and Leanne thrive in it, thrive. But that doesn't mean it's without challenge. I mean, she had a challenging weekend. She shot her wedding. Her dad is currently still alive, but again, he's on hospice. So she's managing her weddings around the potential passing of our father. It's pretty serious. I hope that you found this useful, or at least it gave you something to think about if you are getting into weddings, considering weddings, or maybe even if you're shooting weddings and you haven't thought about it. The thing about getting connected with your core values is understanding that all of your decisions are made before you encounter them. So because I know who I am, what I want, Everything I do and face in regards to weddings, I had already made that decision in my mind before encountering it. Because if you don't think about this stuff and then it happens, you're going to be blindsided and you're not going to know what to do. I had planned, it's just my nature, planned ahead of time, like, okay, what if something happens, especially to one of my children? How would I manage that? Well, when you're a wedding photographer and you're committed and they hired you, they want you and it's their wedding. So you're gonna have to suck it up, buttercup, and shoot the wedding. That's what we do. I'll see you in the next video.